Does it trouble you?
Not really.
What's important is that your mark is now stable, as is the breach. You've given us time, and Solas believes a second attempt might succeed, provided the mark has more power. The same level of power used to open the breach in the first place. That is not easy to come by.
Clearly you have something in mind.
We do. You've met Commander Cullen, leader of the Inquisition's forces.
It was only for a moment on the field. I'm pleased you survived.
This is Lady Josephine Montelier, our ambassador and chief diplomat.
I've heard much. It's a pleasure to meet you at last.
And of course, you know Sister Liliana.
My position here involves a degree of...
She is our spymaster.
Yes, tactfully put, Cassandra.
Pleased to meet you all.
I mentioned that your mark needs more power to close the breach for good.
Which means we must approach the rebel mages for help.
And I still disagree. The Templars could serve just as well.
We need power, Commander. Enough magic poured into that mark.
Might destroy us all. Templars could suppress the breach, weaken it, so...
Pure speculation.
I was a Templar. I know what they're capable of.
Unfortunately, neither group will even speak to us yet. The Chantry has denounced the Inquisition, and you specifically.
Can't you simply ignore them?
If only that were possible. Some are calling you the Herald of Andraste, and that frightens the Chantry. The remaining clerics have declared it blasphemy, and we heretics for harboring you.
Chancellor Roderick's doing, no doubt.
It limits our options. Approaching the mages or Templars for help is currently out of the question.
Just how am I the Herald of Andraste?
People saw what you did at the temple, how you stopped the breach from growing. They have also heard about the woman seen in the rift when we first found you. They believe that was Andraste.
Even if we tried to stop that view from spreading...
Which we have not.
The point is, everyone is talking about you.
It's quite the title, isn't it? How do you feel about that?
I don't mind it at all.
People are desperate for a sign of hope. For some, you're that sign. And to others, a symbol of everything that's gone wrong.
They aren't more concerned about the breach. The real threat.
They do know it's a threat. They just don't think we can stop it.
The Chantry is telling everyone you'll make it worse. There is something you can do. A Chantry cleric by the name of Mother Giselle has asked to speak to you. She is not far, and knows those involved far better than I. Her assistance could be invaluable.
I'll see what she has to say.
You will find Mother Giselle tending to the wounded in the hinterlands near Redcliffe.
Look for other opportunities to expand the Inquisition's influence while you're there.
We need agents to extend our reach beyond this valley, and you're better suited than anyone to recruit them.
In the meantime, let's think of other options. I won't leave this all to the Herald.
We are garnering interest from the capital.
You're not pleased.
I am not convinced we are prepared for the full scrutiny of Valroyo.
work?
Let's see what we have.
The Inquisition cannot remain ambassador if you can't prove it was founded on Justinia's orders.
This is an inopportune time, Marquis. More of the faithful flock here each day. But allow me to introduce you to the brave soul who risked his life to slow the magic of the breach. Sir Trevelyan, may I present the Marquis Durelion, one of Divine Justinia's greatest supporters.
And the rightful owner of Haven. House Durelion lent Justinia these lands for pilgrimage. This Inquisition is not a beneficiary of this arrangement.
This is the first I've heard of Haven having an owner outside the Chantry.
My wife, Lady Machin of Denner, has claim to Haven by ancient treaty with the monarchs of Ferelden. We were honored to lend its use to Divine Justinia. She was a woman of supreme merit. I will not let an upstart order remain on her holy grounds.
People have been injured. You can't just turn them out onto the snow.
And who benefits if they stay?
Divine Justinia, Marquis. The Inquisition, not the Chantry, is sheltering the pilgrims who mourn her.
Why is the Chantry ignoring the faithful?
Because it remains in shock. We face a dark time, Your Grace. Divine Justinia would not want her passing to divide us. She would, in fact, trust us to forge new alliances to the benefit of all, no matter how strange they might seem.
I'll think on it, Lady Montillier. The Inquisition might stay in the meanwhile.
Do the Durelions actually have a claim on this place?
His Grace's position is not so strong as he presents it. Despite their Ferelden relations, the Durelions are Orlesian. If the Marquis wishes to claim Haven, Empress Selene must negotiate with the Ferelden on his behalf. Her current concerns are a bit larger than minor property disputes.
I apologize for the intrusion. I didn't realize you were meeting with the Marquis.
You did little harm. In truth, the debate was most beneficial as practice for those to come.
You expect more people in Haven?
Undoubtedly. And each visitor will spread the story of the Inquisition after they depart. An ambassador should ensure the tale is as complimentary as possible.
May I ask what brought you to work for the Inquisition?
Sister Leliana approached me. We've been acquainted for quite some time. For better or worse, being the Inquisition's diplomat has become as interesting as she promised.
What sort of dealings have you had with nobility?
For some years, I was the royally appointed court ambassador from Antiva to Orlais. The nobility of Thedas is a rather singular sphere. Those I'm not acquainted with, I know through reputation.
The Inquisition is lucky to have you as an advocate, Lady Montillier.
Thank you. Let us hope so. Thedas's politics have become agitated as of late. I hope to guide us down smoother paths. But please excuse me. I've much work to do before the day is done.
You're the Herald. Or, well, the one they're calling the Herald, anyway. I hope the Inquisition can restore order soon. I never really wanted to leave the Circle. My name is Mnave. I research demons and other creatures. Seeker Pentagast and I use what I find to help the soldiers fight them.
I found something the demons left behind. Can you use it?
Yes, that's very helpful.
Just leave it there, and the Tranquil and I will examine it. Yes. Good.
Though you had granted them power over the very fade itself, though they sang hymns of praise unending, though they could do anything, they did not.
You dislike the Templar system?
No. I know their purpose, but you remember I once enlisted in a solar charge. Yes, I assumed you were using the Templar around keeping us. The pages of the circle follow the charge of light as faithfully as the Templar system.
More faithfully than some Templars even. Some of the things that...
No, my lord, I don't know where the other nobles are. I suggest you ask Ambassador Montillier. Oh, you're him. Thryn, Inquisition Quartermaster. I'm doing what I can to supply this mess. If you find what I need to fill one of my requisitions, I'd appreciate you bringing it in.
What do you do here?
I make sure the Inquisition troops have food in their bellies and iron in their hands. Both are important. Lots of people expecting us to be heroes, marching all day to fight the demons. Turns out heroes need to dig latrines just like everyone else.
How does someone end up as quartermaster for the Inquisition?
I served Ferelden under Ten Loghain MacTyr, best commanding officer this world has ever seen. After they all turned on him at Denerim, though, there wasn't much use for people who held that opinion. King Alistair offered my services to the Inquisition, probably to get rid of me.
Loghain MacTyr betrayed the Grey Wardens and his king.
Were you there at Ostagar? I was. King Caelan overextended his position, and the Grey Wardens were too late lighting a signal. Following the original plan would have gotten everyone killed. Ten Loghain made the right decision. I apologize. Sister Liliana told me I shouldn't talk about this. Just forget it.
What did you mean when you mentioned requisitions?
I'm making this Inquisition run with what we have. But we're not a real army. We're stretched thin on materials. So I've put up a requisition list for anything that could help our people. Here, take a look. You find some iron and a good logging site. Maybe Varric can get our troops better weapons.
If I have material for a special order, do I bring it to you?
Just take it over there. One of my boys will take the materials or jot down what you found.
Farewell.
Make a go with you.
Greetings.
How do you and Liliana know each other?
We moved through similar circles in Norlai. I believe we actually met in Val Royale. Liliana was quite an accomplished player of the game by then.
What exactly do you mean when you say the game?
Ah, forgive me. The game refers to the slow duels of influence among the noble and powerful of Orlais. It's a rather light-hearted name for the matter, but Orlesians are fond of playful touches.
What business are the Montilliers in exactly?
We began as merchants. My ancestors founded the first trade routes to Rivain. We once sent entire fleets across the Waking Sea.
But not anymore.
Ah, no. These days, our vessels are a touch more modest.
That's where our families have met before.
Perhaps. Everyone of distinction in the Free Marches attends Lady Trevelyan's summer balls.
Great Aunt Lucille always did love a party.
I don't recall seeing you at any of them.
I was less than sterling company when I was younger.
Modest in temper, bold in deed.
You know the Trevelyan family motto?
Heraldry is a passion of mine.
What did you do before coming here?
I had the great honor of serving Antiva's crown as ambassador to Orlais. I'm also first in line to become the head of House Montilier, though my siblings attend to our mercantile affairs.
How strong are your past loyalties?
I would never have given up my position if I did not intend to fully commit to the Inquisition. We cannot fall back on borders. Antiva is as threatened as any country by the rebellions. If anything, the alliances I forged there may help our current cause.
Do you think the Inquisition will continue after we seal the breach?
If we prove ourselves by healing the breach, people may turn to us for other things. Protection, counsel, justice. The Inquisition offered these once to those in need.
Tell me, do you believe I was saved by Andraste at the Temple of Sacred Ashes?
I should much like to believe so, Your Worship. The miracles Andraste performed were so long ago, they're difficult to picture. If it were truly her and the fate who saved you... Well, in any case, many already believe you walk in the Maker's Light.
Let's speak later.
Farewell. Good day to you.
What exactly does your job entail?
I meet with ambassadors from various factions and countries, and cement alliances with them. We are a young cause. Diplomacy is essential to our credibility.
Then you speak for the Inquisition with these nobles?
I do. Someone must foster goodwill on our behalf, as well as prevent controversy as news of us spreads.
How heavily are our actions scrutinized?
Make no mistake. Every noble house, every throne, is waiting to see what the Inquisition does next. Many are willing to pledge support, if offers are made in just the right fashion. I intend to see that they are.
Tell me how you came to work for the Inquisition again.
I'd been considering leaving my post in Antiva for a new challenge when Liliana recruited me. There's such unrest in Thedas, and the Inquisition seems a promising method to stop it. It's to everyone's benefit if we prevent the Mage-Templar conflict from spreading further.
So was it the prospect of stability that drew you here?
The full impact of the Mage Rebellion has yet to be felt, and that was before the death of the Divine. The violence must be curbed before we see it turn to full-scale war.
I can only imagine the bloodshed if it escalates further.
I'm afraid history holds many examples of what will happen if it does.
What do the people make of us?
Despite our fame, we're low on steadfast allies. We must aim for more.
Any visiting dignitaries I should watch out for?
Sir Griffith of Denerim, a most distinguished knight of the realm. He's defeated darkspawn, slain demons, chased down abominations. Just don't ask him about it over dinner. He spares no detail.
Though you had granted them power over the very fade itself, though they stand here...
Thank you.
Blessed are the peacekeepers, the champions of the just. Blessed are the righteous, the lights in the shadow. In their blood, the Maker's will is written. Is that what you want from us? Blood? To die so that your will is done? Is death your only blessing? You speak Fandrastain, no? What does the Maker's prophet have to say about all of this? What's his game?
How is this a game?
Do you see the sky? What about the temple ruins? The bones lying in the dust? Even if you didn't support the Divine's peace, you wouldn't call this right. Who could? So many innocent lives. The faithful murdered where the holiest of holies once stood. If the Maker willed this, what is it if not a game or a cruel joke?
Awful things happen every day. Get used to it.
Get used to being a pawn? To be discarded when the Maker's done with you? The Chantry teaches that the Maker abandoned us. He demands repentance for our sins. He demands it all. Our lives, our deaths. Justinia gave him everything she had, and he let her die.
I'm sorry. Her death has clearly hit you hard.
Not just me. All of us. She was the Divine. She led the faithful. She was the heart. If the Maker doesn't intervene to save the best of his servants, what good is he? I used to believe I was chosen, just as some say you are. I thought I was fulfilling his purpose for me, working with the Divine, helping people. But now she's dead. It was all for nothing. Serving the Maker meant nothing.
Maybe you have another purpose. I could help you find it.
No, this is my burden. I regret that I even let you see me like this. It was a moment of weakness. It won't happen again. Come, to work then. We will speak later.
Chosen of Andraste, a blessed hero sent to save us all.
Am I riding in on a shining steed?
I would have suggested a griffon, but sadly they're extinct. Joke as you will, posturing is necessary. I've journeyed deep into the Fade in ancient ruins and battlefields to see the dreams of lost civilizations. I've watched as hosts of spirits clash to reenact the bloody past in ancient wars, both famous and forgotten. Every great war has its heroes. I'm just curious what kind you'll be.
What do you mean, ruins and battlefields?
Any building strong enough to withstand the rigors of time has a history. Every battlefield is steeped in death. Both attract spirits. They press against the veil, weakening the barrier between our worlds. When I dream in such places, I go deep into the Fade. I can find memories no other living being has ever seen.
You fall asleep in the middle of ancient ruins. Isn't that dangerous?
I do set wards. And if you leave food out for the giant spiders, they are usually content to live and let live.
If you go that deep into the Fade, you might find something better left alone.
I take precautions to avoid possession. I have no wish to become a demon's tool. In the same light, be cautious here. Cassandra's protection only lasts so long as she survives. It will be interesting to watch this fledgling Inquisition make its way. I will stay to see it, for now.
Was that in doubt?
I am an apostate surrounded by Chantry forces in the middle of a mage rebellion. Cassandra has been accommodating, but you understand my caution.
Cassandra trusts you. You won't let anyone put you into a circle against your will.
Thank you. I appreciate the thought. But now let us hope either the mages or the Templars have the power to seal the breach. Closing the... Greetings.
What do you know about the Fade?
A great deal, for my wandering. There are a few hard facts, but I can share what I have learned.
I'd like to know more about the breach.
Simply put, it is a tear in the veil between this world and the Fade, allowing spirits to enter the world physically. Small tears occur naturally when magic weakens the veil, or when spirits cluster at an area that has seen many deaths. But your mark allows you to exert some control over the breach. That means it was created deliberately.
I'd like to know more about the veil.
Circle mages call it a barrier between this world and the Fade, but according to my studies in ancient Elven lore, that is a vast oversimplification. Without it, imagine if spirits entered freely. The Fade was not a place one went, but a state of nature like the wind.
We've got enough trouble with demons already.
But would they still be demons? Or would they be part of a natural environment, like a fast-flowing river? Yes, it can drown careless children, but it can also carry a merchant's goods or grind a miller's flour. That is what the world could be if the veil were not present. For better or worse.
I'd like to know more about demons.
The Chantry says that demons hate the natural world and seek to bring their chaos and destruction to the living. But such simplistic labels misconstrue their motivations, and in so doing, do all a great disservice. Spirits wish to join the living, and a demon is that wish gone wrong.
I doubt those things pouring out of the breach wanted to join the living. Eat, maybe.
Of course demons are destructive. This world is illicit and unnatural for them. They fight to gain entrance, and when the rules of this world do not mirror theirs, they lash out. Tragic, not evil.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye. Greetings.
I'd like to know more about you, Solas.
Why?
You're an elven mage. Not from the Circle, not Dalish. You're an unknown element. I wouldn't trust my life to a blade before I'd tested its balance.
Nor would I. All right. What can I tell you?
What made you start studying the Fade?
I grew up in a village to the north. There was little to interest a young man, especially one gifted with magic. But as I slept, spirits of the Fade showed me glimpses of wonders I had never imagined. I treasured my dreams. Being awake, out of the Fade, became troublesome.
Did spirits try to tempt you?
No more than a brightly colored fruit is deliberately tempting you to eat it. I learned how to defend myself from more aggressive spirits and how to interact safely with the rest. I learned how to control my dreams with full consciousness. There was so much I wanted to explore.
I gather you didn't spend your entire life dreaming.
No. Eventually, I was unable to find new areas in the Fade.
Why?
Two reasons. First, the Fade reflects the world around it. Unless I traveled, I would never find anything new. Second, the Fade reflects and is limited by our imaginations. Find interesting areas, one must be interesting.
Is this why you joined the Inquisition?
I joined the Inquisition because we were all in terrible danger. If our enemies destroyed the world, I would have nowhere to lay my head while dreaming of the Fade.
The only reason you live your life is to be able to see more of the Fade.
Yes.
That's no way to live.
You strengthen your body to deliver and withstand punishment. The muscles are an enjoyable side benefit. You have chosen a path whose steps you do not dislike because it leads to a destination you enjoy. As have I.
You said you traveled to many different places.
This world, or its memory, is reflected in the Fade. Dream in ancient ruins, and you may see a city lost to history. Some of my fondest memories were found in crumbling cities, long picked dry by treasure seekers, the best of the battlefields. Spirits press so tightly on the veil that you can slip across with but a thought.
Any place in particular?
I dreamt at Ostagar. I witnessed the brutality of the Darkspawn and the valor of the Ferelden warriors. I saw Alistair and the hero Ferelden light the signaled fire. and Loghain's infamous betrayal of Kaelin's forces.
I've heard the stories. It would be interesting to hear what it was really like.
That's just it. In the Fade, I see reflections created by spirits who react to the emotions of the warriors. One moment, I see heroic wardens lighting the fire and a power-mad villain sneering as he lets King Kaelin fall. The next, I see an army overwhelmed and a veteran commander refusing to let more soldiers die in a lost cause.
You can't tell which is real.
It is the Fade. They are all real.
Have you always traveled and studied alone?
Not at all. I have built many lasting friendships. Spirits of wisdom, possessed of ancient knowledge, happy to share what they had seen. Spirits of purpose helped me search. Even wisps, curious and playful, would point out treasures I might have missed.
I don't know of any spirits by those names.
They rarely seek this world. When they do, their natures do not often survive exposure to the people they encounter. Wisdom and purpose are too easily twisted to pride and desire.
You're saying that you became friends with pride and desire demons?
They were not demons for me.
Meaning?
The Fade reflects the minds of the living. If you expect a spirit of wisdom to be a pride demon, it will adapt. And if your mind is free of corrupting influences, if you understand the nature of the spirit, they can be fast friends.
When I asked if you were with anyone, I meant other people.
Ah, people, as opposed to spirits. We are flesh and blood, so we are real. Is Cassandra defined by her cheekbones and not her faith? Varric by his chest hair and not his wit?
Spirits are bound by their nature. You said it yourself. They're shaped by contact with real people.
Just as Liliana was shaped by contact with Divine Justinian. As those who serve the Inquisition are shaped by you. If I change your mind in this conversation, does that mean you're no more real than a spirit?
You've thought about this.
On occasion, yes.
We'll talk later.
Of course.
Told me that he can't let the herbs go for anything less than 8.
Fine. We'll gather our own. Tell Segret, he better hope he doesn't need a salve anytime soon. Look who's back from the dead. Again.
I don't recall meeting you before.
I'd be surprised if you did. You weren't particularly coherent. Someone had to patch you up after you staggered out of making those wear, though. So, you're welcome.
I didn't realize. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, you can pay me back by fixing the world. Name's Adan. I'm in charge of keeping our little band here stocked with potions and elixirs. Not that Seeker Pentagast seems to care whether we've got the supplies to actually do that.
For a healer, you don't seem particularly nurturing.
I'm not a healer. I'm an alchemist who's forced to play Mother Hen. You want something to burst into flame on contact with the air? Done. Gladly. Patching up wounded soldiers is a waste of my time and talents. But there are a few around who can help.
How are your people holding up?
There's no shortage of work. That's for damn sure.
Is there anything I can do to help out?
We're fine as far as raw labor goes. You've more important things to do than tend to me. I only wish I'd been able to find Master Tajin's notes. Old bastard was working on something special. He died at the Conclave, and his notes weren't here. Been too busy dealing with the wounded to look for them.
How do I go about having potions made?
Just take a look there and tell me what you'd like. Find a recipe for something better, I can make that too. Perhaps another time.
Out in the hinterlands, the irregular.
Would that I could.
Right.
massive thought you are, Flitter.
Welcome back.
Sure.
And I can go back right away.
Oh, Maker, you him? You were the herald of Andraste. She sent you to us to show the world her love, and I am ready for that love. Well, I'm not ready for that kind of love. That is, unless that's what you want. But, I mean, I'm Flitter. Can I get you a drink?
I'm here with the Maker's blessing, and I'll do whatever I can to help.
Then I... Oh, what could you need from me? Oh, I'm rushing. As I said, I'm Flitter. The Inquisition soldiers needed a place to unwind, so Leliana brought me in to set up a tavern. Nothing fancy, but it's safer for the soldiers than looking for trouble at some village.
You said Leliana asked you to run an Inquisition tavern. How did you meet?
Dumb luck, mainly. I managed an inn back in Denerin. When I heard interesting gossip, I passed word to Leliana. Sometimes it's helpful. She asked if I wanted to own my own tavern, and I said yes. I didn't realize she meant this.
What can you tell me about this area?
Adana's Haven's apothecary. He's been making potions and tending to the wounded as best he can. Harris is the Inquisition smith. Whatever he can make you, Thren the quartermaster can probably find. And for anything fancier, you can try buying from Segrit. His prices aren't too high. Yet? Oh, there's also Minerve. She studies beasts.
Farewell.
So, now that Cassandra's out of earshot, are you holding up all right? I mean, you go from being the most wanted criminal in Thedas to joining the armies of the faithful. Most people would have spread that out over more than one day.
I don't even want to think about how many lives were lost on that mountaintop.
A lot of good men and women didn't make it out of there. For days now, we've been staring at the breach, watching demons and Maker knows what fall out of it. Bad for morale would be an understatement. I still can't believe anyone was in there and lived.
If it was that bad, why did you stay? Cassandra said you were free to go.
I like to think I'm as selfish and irresponsible as the next guy, but this... Thousands of people died on that mountain. I was almost one of them. And now there's a hole in the sky. Even I can't walk away and just leave that to sort itself out.
The breach needs to be sealed. The sooner the better.
If it can be sealed, you might want to consider running at the first opportunity. I've written enough tragedies to recognize where this is going. Heroes are everywhere. I've seen that. But the hole in the sky, that's beyond heroes. We're going to need a miracle.
Need something?
I've read your Tale of the Champion, and I have a few questions.
That's a pretty common reaction. Go ahead.
In the book, you say that first Enchanter Orsino turned himself into a giant monster made of corpses. How? Why?
Do I look like an expert on magical weirdness to you? Well, I can't tell you how. For the why, all I can say is he was desperate.
There is no way Hawk really could have killed the Arishok. It would have started a war with the Qunari.
I was told later that the Qunari disavowed his actions. Apparently the Arishok didn't get permission before he attacked Kirkwall, and the Qun didn't want another exalted march. When they finally sent a ship to haul the Red Dreadnought away, they just said, "We will never speak of this again."
But
as far as I can tell, that's the Kuhn's version of an apology.
Where are the rest of Hawk's associates now?
Meryl decided to look after the elves left homeless by the fighting. She's done a pretty good job of keeping them away from the mages and Templars, so far. I guess she has plenty of practice avoiding stupid human battles with her old Dalish clan. Isabella went back to the Raiders. She's calling herself an admiral now. I don't know if she's actually in charge or just has a really big hat. Might be the same thing, honestly. Sebastian went back to Starkhaven. I'm sure he's boring all sorts of people there. Hawk's brother Carver is still in the Free Marches, helping the Kirkwall Guard keep order. Aveline is still guard captain. I'm pretty sure Kirkwall would fall into the sea if she quit her job. Need something?
Can I ask you something, Varric?
You want to talk about me? I'm flattered. Also inclined toward extravagant lies.
Are you from Ferelden? Olé?
Free Marches. Born and raised in Kirkwall. And despite whatever you've heard, no. Kirkwall's not that bad.
I'm not clear on your line of work. You're a merchant.
I'm a businessman. My family has a seat in the Dwarven Merchants Guild. Merchants buy and sell goods. Businessmen buy and sell stores. In my spare time, I manage a spy network, and occasionally, I write books.
If you've run a spy network, why is Leliana our spymaster?
To be honest with you, she's just a better spymaster. The truly great ones can keep their distance. They don't get attached to their people. Me, I always wind up babysitting my informants and worrying about their families. We're in better hands with her.
You're an author. What kind of books have you written?
I've tried my hands at a few genres. My crime serials are my most popular. Hard in Hightown, guards breaking the rules to get things done. The Tale of the Champion is the most famous thing I've written, or infamous, maybe. I started a romance serial once, Swords and Shields, but to be honest, I don't have a knack for romances. Most of my stories end in tragedy. Probably that says something unfortunate about me personally.
What sort of shops do you own?
Actually, we don't own shops. That was just an example. Mostly we invest in moneylenders. Auction houses, a few mercenary companies, a couple of smithies. I think we own half a beet plantation in Ravain somewhere. Most of that's my brother's doing. Bartrand had business sense. Not much tact, but loads of business sense.
How do you and Cassandra know each other?
You heard about the Kirkwall Chantry being destroyed? The guy responsible used to be a friend of mine. The Seeker had questions about that, and I had answers.
Where did you get that crossbow? I've never seen one like it.
Bianca? She's one of a kind. I got her off a guy in Darktown. Took me a week to pry his dead fingers off the stock.
Who's she named for?
I can't tell you.
And the reason for that is?
Complicated. It's the one story I'll never tell. We just have to leave it at that.
Thanks, Varric.
No problem.
Siege equipment. They're not laying siege to anything.
That's an excellent point, recruit. But if someone comes to lay siege to us...
Here. Tell Mother Giselle that this is a... Ah, you're awake and out of Lady Cassandra's clutches. And here I paid that little knife ear to inform me the moment you were free. No matter, no matter. Segret, honored to meet you. Thank you for all you've done, and hopefully will still do.
What do you think I'll be doing exactly?
Word's already spreading that if anyone can close that blighted thing in the sky, it's you. Anything you need is yours. For a reasonable price, of course. Supplies are a little tight, given the circumstances.
What kind of person stays to run a shop at a time like this?
The kind with nowhere else to go. Those blasted demons destroy most of my goods. If I stay here, work some contacts, I can start rebuilding. Maybe, just maybe, help you folks out in the process.
You must speak with most everyone here. How are people doing?
Hope and fear in equal measure. No one really knows what it means when an Inquisition is called. Yet. I imagine it's no better for you. You've got my sympathies, for what it's worth.
Until later.
Stay safe.
Still got demons pouring out of the rifts. You're worried about the rift. I understand that. Good luck sealing those rifts.